The following presentation was recorded at the Buddhist Society of Victoria, Malvern East, Australia. Please visit our website at bsv.net.au.
So we'll do, it works out well, 40-minute meditation. And I will guide the first 15 or 20 minutes, and then afterwards I'll be quiet. The reason I do this is just so to get you going. And then if I kept on talking all the time, it would take away your ability to explore the meditation and to find your own wisdom of how to go deeper. But the first 10 or 15 minutes is where I can make sure you get on the right track to begin with, and then leave it up to you. So we close our eyes. The purpose of closing your eyes in this form of meditation is because it gives you more space inside of your brain to be able to feel the body and to listen to the sounds. It's one sense, one of the major senses which you don't have to waste time on, or visual data. I just stopped for a while. And we begin by feeling our body, not with our hands, but with our mind. What do I mean by that? When you see a doctor, the doctor says, "How do you feel?" It may be you've had an operation on your hand. So does your hand feel now? And that question means the patient puts their awareness on their hand and can report to the doctor the symptoms. In the same way, when you ask your own legs, how do you feel? It sends your mindfulness to that area of your body. You become aware of the feelings in your legs. And you get to know whether they're in the best position for this meditation. And you don't just endure. If your legs, you realize that they're not in the best position, then experiment. Change the position of your legs. But change them mindfully, awareness. So you feel them before and after the change, to see whether it's a change for the good or whether it's just making things worse. This way the mindfulness and the wisdom begin to grow. You're aware of the best position for your legs this morning, which may not be the same position as yesterday. And then you're aware of the feelings in your buttocks. Because I always see people fidgeting during meditation, if I keep my eyes open. And the reason is because we just take that part of our body for granted. We just plonk our butt down on a chair or cushion. But paying some attention to it, adjusting it, making sure the cushion's just on the right place, really helps later on. And then you become, ask your back, how's your back right now? Physiotherapists have told me the most comfortable position, according to what they know, for your back is to be leaning backwards from the vertical about 15 degrees, which is exactly the inclination of the backrest of most chairs. So if you wish to lean back, fine. If you want to lean forward and keep a straight back, fine. If you want to slump, fine. You find the best position for your body now. Because people usually have tension in their shoulders, I pay special attention to my shoulders and relax. How do I relax the tightness in my shoulder blades? Those muscles, I imagine that those muscles are like a bunch of strings being pulled apart. And I let go of both ends. And in that little mental exercise, that imagination, I find my own muscles, the real ones, they also relax. And I can feel relaxation happening. I'm aware, and the awareness gives me feedback of how to relax my own shoulder muscles. As for my hands, I was just taught when I was young to put my right hand over my left hand, thumb slightly touching. But you don't need to do that. I become aware of how my hands are right now. And I relax them. And I go back up to my shoulders and my neck, making sure my head is well balanced on top of the neck. Because I have a little irritation in my throat, I don't try to get rid of that irritation. Just aware of it. Just what the body does. It's a croaky voice. That's okay. I make my peace with it. When I make peace with it, it gets a little bit better. If I try to heal it, if I have negativity towards it, it gets worse. It's interesting to see, to experiment. You know how to make peace with your own body, or what makes symptoms worse. And I go to my face. I have muscles around my eyes and my mouth, maybe my forehead. That tells me any emotional stress in my mind being played out in my facial muscles. When I relax the muscles around my eyes, relax the muscles around my mouth, it's like I'm also relaxing my emotional world. And no fear, no aspirations, just peace, just being here, just taking a break, just from the striving of life. I've worked so hard, come so far. Now I'm just going to sit down and enjoy this moment. And once my body starts to relax, I feel the whole body is relaxed to the max, and it actually feels delightful. Feel my body. It's like it says, thank you for paying attention to me. Thank you for caring for me. And I get this delight My whole body like it's been to a Californian spa. I feel so at ease and relaxed. And I indulge in that. And my body gets more relaxed. When it's the right time, I turn to my emotional world, my peaceometer. From 1 to 10, how peaceful am I? I look at that needle which gives me the feedback. And I experiment, if you don't know already, what makes your mind more peaceful? What makes it agitated? What turns the needle up towards 10? What lowers the needle closer towards 1? What's the cause of peace, stillness? And you'll notice thinking. Thinking is the inner speech. It talks back to the world. And when you're talking, you're not listening. In silence, you listen. You're aware, receiving information. You get peaceful. And any future thoughts? Your future is being made right now. This is the only time you have. If you make this moment peaceful and kind, you're doing the very, very best for your future by being still now. So don't get deceived into planning. And in this moment, sometimes you can hear the sound of the cars or the birds. Sometimes you can feel your breathing. As the breath comes in naturally, as the breath goes out according to its nature. Just being with your breath, not controlling it, but treating it like a friend. Focusing on the breath, the delightful breath. You've got nothing in the whole world you have to achieve. No tests, no exams, nothing to prove. Just being with the breathing. Kind, peaceful. And try to listen to this world. Don't get caught up into thinking and commentating. The space between the thoughts. I'm going to be silent now. The next time I start talking, in about 15, 20 minutes, we'll be close to the end of the meditation. getting close to the end of the meditation. How do you feel? How peaceful is the body? How relaxed is the mind? And how much delight, delight in silence and peace. Oh, now ring the gong 3 times to end this meditation. So I hope you got some nice peace and enjoyment out of that 40-minute meditation.